Hey guys, it's Charlie. It's September 1st, Tuesday. And if you want to know how a government-run stimulus program works, let's look at cash for clunkers. Now keep in mind, a month ago, when all of our representatives came home, they wanted to talk the success of cash for clunkers when they opened the door to it and people immediately decided to go ahead and take the free money of $4,000 and go into debt further and destroy a vehicle that in most cases was paid off. Okay, that's the program in a nutshell. It looks good on paper. I mean, it looks good in talking point memos, because you can say you're actually doing something for industry and you're doing something to stimulate the economy, but in reality it's an idiotic plan that has now failed, and I can prove it. Ford, the last American-owned auto company in this country, did have a good month, 17% increase over August of last year, 2008. Toyota and Honda, now if you're a foreign-owned auto manufacturer, you know, the government really bailed you out, foreign companies, so thank them for that, because Toyota was up 10%, Honda was up over 14%. But the two companies that you and I own, the ones that are now Government Motors and Chrysler, I don't even know what that is, quasi-American slash Italian company, they had just real spectacular performances in cash for clunkers. General Motors, 20.2% decrease August over August, and Chrysler, 15.4% decrease August over August. Now, these numbers were hideous. As a matter of fact, they were worse than the prior month when they had no cash for clunkers. In July, sales for General Motors were down 19% July over July. Well, they got into August with cash for clunkers and did even worse. Chrysler, the same story. In July, they were down 9.4% over July 2008, and then they stepped into cash for clunkers and managed to shed another 6% in sales. So just a perfect example of how it was expedient at the time for these politicians to go on television and tout their successes, okay? But the fact of the matter is, it was successful for foreign companies. It was successful for the only company that is still, for the most part, a privately owned company, Ford. But these entities that we now own, well, they sucked before cash for clunkers, and now they suck worse. So, you know, in my opinion, the same thing is going to happen in the new real estate boom that mainstream media wants us to believe is underway. A couple months in a row of increased sales. You know, the number one reason we're seeing increased sales, because like cash for clunkers, the federal government is bribing people to the tune of $8,000 to go out and buy a house for the first time. That's the number one reason. The number two reason is because they've had nothing but propaganda and cheerleaders going out for the last 6 months saying the bottom is in, the housing bottom is in, everything's going to be peaches and cream from here on in, and you're a fool if you don't take advantage of the time to buy a home now. Well, a lot of people have stepped up, taken the free $8,000, and in some states they've doubled that. So the state's matching, so maybe they're getting $16,000 or their down payment basically, just to go in and to get a home that is being short sold or foreclosed sale. So, but that well is going to run dry in November, and definitely we're going to see further decrease in housing prices and further decrease in sales as well. You know, and the thing about it is, you almost have to feel sorry for someone who is buying a home in these times under these conditions, because you know most realists understand that to buy a home now is almost like it's always been to buy a car. As soon as you drive it off the lot, boom, 20% of it's gone. You know, so you go buy a house now. If you pay $150,000 for it, you can almost be rest assured that by the time you make your first mortgage payment, that your free government $8,000 is probably eaten up on the value that you lost in that first month. You know, if it didn't lose it in the first month, it's going to certainly lose it in the first quarter. But, you know, whatever. Another gimmick, just like Cash for Clunkers, we're seeing gimmick after gimmick that is designed to enhance their image as doing something for the economy, when really all they're doing is putting more people further into debt. And at the end of the day, the only one who benefits from this are the banks, you know, with guaranteed loans from the on housing. They're going to have guaranteed loans from the government and foreign companies in the case of Cash for Clunkers. So, anyway, that's all I got.